Hey everybody, and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon. Enter the Gungeon. Alright, so last time we played as the Hunter, we're going to be playing as the Marine this time, because this is the other character that I'm good at, and I would like to give you guys a little bit of variety. Alright, we have 8 hegemony credits, because last run we actually did pretty darn good. So, we buy the box. So now, next time, these should all be updated to new stuff. I wonder if it happens immediately. Nope, it'll be probably next run. But we probably won't have enough credits to actually get anything. Alright. Let's do some good stuff this run. I'm feeling pretty good. I got back from my workout today, and I got a little bit of a rest. That was some pretty solid dodging right there, if I do say so myself. Channeling them down this corridor, that was actually really close. It's an infinite ammo weapon, so I don't mind using it to kill the little blobulets. I'm just gonna turn down the volume in my headphones just a little bit. It's a little loud, so I feel like it's making me talk a bit louder than I need to. Oh, wow. I'm not sure how I didn't get hit there, I will be honest. We got some books doing some bad stuff. So at the end of the last episode, if you missed it, if you didn't watch, I kind of went on a little rant about ability in this game and the main skills that it takes advantage of, and I wanted to rehash that briefly, because I think it's worth noting, and I know that there are some people who don't watch all the way through the videos, and I understand, don't worry about it. But, basically, the point that I made, or was trying to back up, you can decide whether or not I argued it well enough to prove it, was that the two main skills in this game are dodging bullets and positioning. Those are the two skills that you use, and if you're good at those two skills, you will be really good at this game. Key is a nice find. So, how did I argue this? Why did I argue this? It really wasn't arguing, it was making a point of thesis, I suppose, if you will. I guess the mirror room has another exit on it. That it does. It's just a brown chest. I don't know if I really want to do that. Increasing your curse means jammed enemies. So, I argue that dodging bullets was one of the skills, because obviously this is a bullet hell, to a degree. It's a roguelike, but it gets bullet helly, especially some of the bosses. So dodging those bullets is a skill. And dodging bullets also kind of has within itself two skills. That is being able to keep track of all the bullets. That, of course, meaning all the bullets that are on screen, which direction they're going, things like that. Being able to keep them all in your mind and not getting surprised by a bullet that came from somewhere that you weren't looking for. So it's a combination of don't get tunnel vision. Whoa. The bat's there. So that's part of it. And then the other skill is being able to predict where all the bullets are going. So it becomes... The reason why I posit those are the two skills that make up dodging bullets is because if you are good at... You need to be good at both of them to actually be able to dodge bullets. Because if you can't predict where the bullets are going, then you're not going to be able to actually dodge them. You're just going to move around and probably get hit. But if you can't keep track of all the bullets, then you're going to get hit by bullets that you can't see. So without those two fundamental parts, you won't be able to dodge bullets. But overall, the goal of both of those skills is being able to dodge bullets. That's why I don't call them out as separate skills in the upper two, which is dodging bullets and positioning. Positioning, I consider to be a skill. Sure, green's worth opening. Is that right, this one? Proton backpack. Okay, we're going Ghostbusters. Excuse me. Positioning is the other skill. And positioning is a skill on the same level of dodging bullets, because, well, I wonder if that's more effective. Okay, so this actually travels really slow. That's really odd. Ooh, Winchester. Winchester, not bad. Oh, and this guy. Ballot. Costs a key. Book of chest anatomy. Brick of cash. I actually want the brick of cash. Secrets of the Mason. So I know about this one. It tells you where the secret rooms are, and I think that spending two keys on that will, in the end, get me more stuff. Anyway, so to go back to what I was saying, positioning can reduce the... If you're good at positioning, it reduces the need for the ability to dodge bullets. If you are really good at positioning yourself, putting yourself in a place that doesn't basically put you in danger, or knowing where it's better for you to be, where what's more safe, like that sort of thing, then you will, in general, have less bullets to dodge. But if you can't do either at all, you're going to be in trouble. If you can't dodge bullets, even if you put yourself in a good position, you're still going to get caught. Eventually. The game's bullet hell-y enough that that's how it'll go. One second. So all of that said, sorry, I'm looking for the secret room, basically. There'll be a little guy pointing it out. I saw this item on a video of somebody else playing, so... Where are you? But yes, so if you can position yourself really well, you'll end up in places that have less bullets. Well, that's unfortunate. Alright. We're gonna go fight the boss. I think that this proton pack is gonna be really good, actually. Yeah, so if you position well, you don't need to dodge bullets as well, but if you're good at dodging bullets, being good at positioning makes it even harder for you to get hit, and that was unfortunate. This is doing decent damage. Also, it reflected that. Nice. We did unfortunately get hit that one time. Not much I can do about that, though. I have the Beholster. That means I really hope... A, I have a ton of money. And B, that makes me hope that I... I'm gonna buy the key to get to this chest. Makes me hope we fight the Beholster next four, because this makes them my friends. Trick gun. No, that's AA. I actually don't know if this gun's any good. Let's go over here. Blow up this. We'll go to our starter gun to do this. Okay, it was health. Not particularly necessary. We don't want to blow up the mirror. It's not actually helpful. Yeah, anyway, back to... talk about the skills just to wrap up. Those are the skills that I think make you good at this game, and I also qualified that with, you need to actually play this game a lot to keep those skills in practice, or play a lot of bullet hell type games in general. Very nice, we got a key. So I'm trying to use the starting gun to be ammo conservative. breaks into a lot of random pieces. Alright. Very linear level so far. Wanted to make sure he didn't miss anything. Keeping a very careful eye to my back to make sure nothing is sneaking up behind me. We killed the ghost, so it's unlikely to happen. But now that I'm turning around here, it very well could happen if something didn't walk the exact way I was expecting. So positioning in this case, I'm using cover. Cover is one use of positioning. It's a very basic use of positioning. But you'll notice, even with good positioning, the enemies eventually closed in on me, and I had to show the ability to dodge bullets. I don't know, I think it's a decent summary of the things that make people good at this game. If you have opinions on that, feel free to put them in the description below. Alright, we found our shop already. The honeycomb's pretty good. I'll have to consider it. That was some very poor aim. Now, obviously, there are some other skills to this game, like being able to aim, stuff like that. But I would argue that most people don't, like, being able to aim is point and click. I would argue with a controller where you actually have to, like, roll in, or go in the right direction, that there's some skill there. There's actually, like, a skill level there. But I would also go so far as to argue that it's a fundamental skill, and I'm not too worried about it. There is some... Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to... I guess I'm gonna have to redact, or add to my list of skills, and say that there's decision-making skills in terms of what weapons to use for which location, or for which situations, and there's always gonna be others that are there. You know, dodge rolling is a skill. I would put it under dodging bullets. But that's me. Because that's what it's fundamentally used for. But once again, my opinion. I so basically... I'm gonna go... There we go. Oh, Jesus. So that bullet moved faster than I expected it to. I forgot those bullets bounce. So here, by positioning myself along the wall, I'm making their path to get to me longer, more predictable, and have more stuff in the way. So I'm using my knowledge and ability in positioning to reduce my chances of getting hit. Doesn't mean I won't get hit. It just makes my life easier. My bullet dodging easier. Alright, so we got ammo. What? That's probably what needs the most ammo. Yep. Fairly simple. Oh, geez. Okay, I got you. All Alright, not too difficult to run. Oh my. I don't even actually know what hit me there. So I failed in my bullet awareness there. Which is probably one of my weaker, being able to keep track of all the bullets on screen. When there gets to be a certain number, I definitely fall a little short. We do have some health on this floor though, so I will recoup that. And that was a fairly simple room. You know, I'm gonna have to double check every room for the dude. The brick of cash. Oh! You're actually in here. This is weird. Uranium amulet, table tech blanks. I kind of want that. Table tech blanks makes it so that every single time. Oh, and then this is immediate after. Every single time that you flip a table, every single time, it makes a blank go off, which is pretty nice. I don't know what the uranium amulet does. We've got a ton of money, like a crap ton of money. I don't know why I have so much money. I mean, sure, I haven't been getting hit a lot, but it's not like I haven't gotten hit. So, I'm not sure. Okay. So I really do need to revisit every room. See where our brick of cash is pointing to for our secret room. Oh, right here. Two keys, okay. Two keys for a blank ain't that bad. Does mean I only have one blank, but means that I'm more willing to open these. This is the sling. I've heard that the sling is in fact outrageous, as it claims. And we'll still have a key for next floor. Basically, by using a blank there, we got to open all the chests on the floor. Okay, this is a one-time use med kit. Which, I think I'd rather have that than the ammo. But that means I'm gonna call in the ammo, pick this up. The only gun I'm short on is this, so I might as well. Am I optimistic or pessimistic? I could even just see what this does. If I'm optimistic, I buy the Prime Primer. I'm filthy stinking rich. I can do it. Oh, I guess I could always buy the honeycomb. I'm optimistic. Our weapons are okay. They're not fantastic, but they're okay. And I'm okay with that. If we fight the Beholster, I'm gonna be so happy. Alright. Is the Beholster third floor boss? Alright, she makes you do a lot of dodging. Okay, that was... You can tell, the sling does a lot of damage. You can just dodge roll over that. I'm in a corner. Okay, I was not very... Oh wow, I actually did it. I no-hit her. Nice! Alright. And the Dungeon Eagle, which is only okay. Alright. Sweet. Optimism for the win. The Sling is a really good boss slayer. It does some really good damage. And even with one blank short of what we would normally have, we managed to do it. So, I actually don't know how good this gun is. It actually seems kind of meh. So, It's about time for us to stop using the sidearm, so I'm probably gonna use the SAA. This is a terrible room. I have to admit that. Alright, we managed to finish that room up. And we only took one damage, so I'll take it, I guess. I want to get rid of those guys first. Okay. I don't know how some of those died. I thought there were more enemies in this room, but sure, I'll take it. I mean, we're eating through bullets is the only downside to this. Very nice. Alright, dead end. That's okay. Alright. Let's go, Marine! Pretty self-explanatory room. I managed to get through it just by sitting there. Sure, it's a green chest. This is the grenade launcher. Ooh, this grenade launcher is like the definition of dangerous. Oh man, we are almost out of bullets. Okay. That is the explosive powder. Chances are I'm not going to end up taking it this run because I have an active item that I want to keep. If I take a whole bunch of damage on this fort, which would of course not be ideal, then I will carry it with me, oh man, until I find something better. Well, what do you know? Perfect timing. That really was perfect timing. Some armor? Armor is both a blessing and a curse. It's more health, but it's at the cost of your next hit not actually losing you red hearts. Which, of course, red hearts are easier to... Did you just fall off of that for no reason? I'm gonna have some shots coming at me. Until I can see him, I'm not gonna be able to know when I can actually fire at him. Kind of some prediction going on there. Luckily worked. Okay, we've seen this room a lot before. I actually want to be over here. Very nice, got a blank. I have not been looking for the little wad of cash. That was actually a little close. I almost failed a prediction there. Don't pop the bubble. What do we have here? Link? Yes, it's Link. He wants us to show him the map. Sure, when I finish this, I will come get an item for you. And hey, look! Here's a secret room. Alright. Sure. We got our blank back, which is basically pure win. Everything we got in there was just gravy. So we also got the flare gun and some health. Yep, I'm in fact still alive. What is this? Shotgakova. I think that looks like an active item, so I'm not gonna take it. Cause you don't know if it's an active item until you use it, which kinda sucks. Might get a free kill out of it. Didn't actually end up doing so, but... Key, very nice. We're doing pretty good in terms of many things. I want to find the buffer. that's buffing this thing. I don't know all the things that he buffs. Die in a fire, literally. Alright, we're down to low ammo again. Are there even enemies in this room? No. Okay. This is gonna meet up. We're probably not taking a bunch of damage here, so we're probably not gonna be using this active item just yet, but I think it's worth carrying with us. Remember that the focus is more on beating the game now. Then it is, oh gosh, we're empty. Alright, using control to pick our next. The flare gun is okay. Wait, I just got an achievement? Oh, it was did I just get an achievement? I saw something pop up in my lower corner. I honestly don't know. Anyway, sorry, that was just checking out the Steam overlay. For a second I thought it was... must have been a message. Somebody must have messaged me. Ballistic bullets, speedier... oh, nice! Ballistic boots. I am fast. Okay. What have we not yet discovered? Down there. Okay. Is that where our boss is? I don't even know if we found our boss room yet. So flare gun's pretty decent. Nice job, map complete. We'll go ahead and show the completed map. We got an achievement progress for the cartographer's assistant. Oh, I got the shock rifle. Ooh, shock rifle's nice. Alright, I could have just teleported back, but I'm gonna walk because I'm so fast. Alright, so before we go, I'm going to go ahead and blow my nose, which means that I'm going to mute you guys so you don't have to listen. Okay. And we're back. So, oh, the box is during the shootout, yep. Movement speed increased. That is really, like, that is a huge movement speed increase. We don't have a lot of passives, but we do have a lot of guns. So, I think I'm going to try using the shock rifle, depending on what we've got here as our fight. Okay, the cannonball rog. You know, I'll be honest, I haven't fought the cannonball rug in a long time. I got myself positioned in a corner, which is of course bad. I actually think I want the sling here. Ah, nothing I can do about that. Basically, this means that when I have the opportunity to shoot him, I can. Oh, that was close. So the goal here is to position yourself far away from him, so you can find the holes in his attack easier. You know, we only got hit once, I'll take it. It's a pretty good fight, if you ask me. What the hell is this? Melted rock. Corpses explode. You know, as cool as that sounds, it's not good enough. I should have blanked some more stuff, is the moral of the story. Pretty much, moral of the story. Yep, we heard the rat popping in. I want to keep this health because I always seem to just be running really low on health, and I want to have it. I want to have it at the right time. Alright, so a room clear weapon. It might be the shock rifle, honestly. We've got the sling. I want to actually see if it tells me how much this heals. Contains a small piece of fairy. Substantial healing. That's all it's going to say. I'm not going to use it until I'm basically on the brink of death to get maximum effect out of it. I will walk away. One of the first times I've gotten here that I haven't gotten the dodge rolls do extra damage thing. Whew. That was kind of close. Oh my gosh, that was close. Alright, so I'm actually going to fill up the SAA, and we're going to use that some more. Because I like it a lot. I think it's a really good gun. It uses a lot of ammo really fast, though. That was close. Right, now that I'm no longer being actively chased... That's not gonna last very long. I think I accidentally killed the guy who was buffing. Otherwise, these guys would be getting buffed as well. I was definitely missing a couple shots there. The fact that the bullets bounce means that even the bullets that I miss can still hit stuff, which is pretty convenient. Increasing your ratio of hitting. So, interesting fact that I just literally just found out is that you can roll into those enemies and they won't hurt you. The zombies. Now, since I don't have the armor, I didn't do enough damage to kill them, but still. So killing him actually increases my ammo efficiency, because he means I have to use more ammo to kill stuff. Blue chest, not sure if worth- Oh, hey, guess what? I only have one blank. Blue chest. Plus one bullets. That's a damage up, I presume. I've read the flavor text on these, but I will read it again because I think it is worth it. Masterwork bullets. Peer-reviewed studies have shown that these bullets are precisely one better than normal bullets. What that one is up to you to find out. Alright, that's a pretty good find. That was... short work. Oh, okay. Gotta be careful. There are some things you really don't want to be next to. Right when they spawn. 20 bullets left. Alright. Let's pick the right gun here. And then, let's revert to the other gun. good timing in terms of bullets. Now, there's a bunch of guns that I haven't used yet that I have. Sorry, guys. Turns out that he ejects casings as he fires, which will make this a little bit easier. I think. Doesn't mean I don't have to remember to be hitting the R button as much, because it'll reload for me. You know I'm gonna try this. I kinda have to. So for those who haven't watched previous episodes, I'm using the bullet casings not falling into nothingness to determine where I can and cannot safely walk, so that I can get to the other side of this chasm. I wasn't entirely sure if I could make that. Alright, so looks like we're gonna make it. So planar lead is one of the things we need for the final bullet. I want to... well, that's... yep, that's the SAA. I just want to... oh, that reloaded. Alright. Yeah, that was really bad. Unfortunately, my positioning put me in a really bad spot. I should say positioning or lack thereof. What do you got to sell me? Potion of gun friendship. I have no idea what that does. Some ammo, some bullets, okay. It's good to know. I have 118 bullets. I have no idea what to do with this. With this much money. Like, I really don't. Especially because I'm keeping this. I guess I'm gonna buy the armor before I leave. That's pretty much the only thing I can think of to do with it. I have to remember that I have 6 shots in this gun. Totally forgot that he explodes. Ever push your luck with those. Fantastic. Take my bullets, you bastard. I will go ahead and reload the sling here, I think. The sling's at half, and I'm gonna want it at full, and the SAA still is about half ammo. And I've got other guns that I can use in the interim if the SAA runs out of bullets. There's a whole bunch of things that I want dead. This is a very large floor. Some good bullet predictions going on there. We are almost out of bullets, however. I was honestly half expecting that to be a Lead Maiden. Oh, the timing though. You gotta admit, the timing on that was legitimately insane. About to run out of bullets, here. Take this. Have I found the secret room yet? I totally don't remember if I found the secret room. Interesting. For a key, I can get an armor. Alright. I need to go back through a whole bunch of rooms and check for my little cash friend. He is a little hard to see. Oof, that was close. He predicts where I'm going, so... You know what? Let's try one of these guns that I haven't used. Actually, I've used the grenade launcher in a previous... Actually, pretty good, turns out. I wonder why it has the star on it. Does that mean it's my favored? Does that mean it's not full? Like, I'm not sure what it means. Oh, wow. That bullet bounced back from behind. I think I just fill up this. Okay. Oh, look! I actually damaged this. I don't have any blanks. To the shop! I have a reason to buy a blank. If he's selling any. 30 is probably worth it. Okay, Ring of Chest Friendship, Ring of Chest Vampirism, Ring of Mimic Friendship. Oh, is it bad that I really want to look these up? It's really bad that I want to look these up, but that may or may not stop me. It may or may not. I'm totally not sitting here looking at the wiki at all. No, definitely. Okay. I'm not interested in any of these. Which actually is rather unfortunate. So, I know that the Ring of Vampirism, of Chest Vampirism, is if you blow up a chest, you get health. Which is tempting. I'm not gonna say it's not tempting, it's totally tempting. However, green is better. Ring of Ethereal Form. Ugh, darn it. I hate that I know this is a one-time use item. I hate you, rat. Thanks for the Ring of Ethereal Form. Yep, I'm aware. So I'm actually not gonna pick up any armor and stuff. Not that I want to use this, but of course it's this guy. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and use the grenade launcher, I think. I do not have any blanks. Oh, wow. If you can avoid dodge rolling here, it is optimal. Well, what? Oh my gosh. Okay, this is ricocheting off of these, which is horrifying. Okay, this is about to explode right in my face. Oh my god, twice in a row? What a cruel, cruel fiend. Oh my gosh. Oh wow, it really was full health. Okay, this is empty, so we're going for the sling now. There are just literally, in general, bullets floating around. Oh my gosh. You fiend, where are you? This is a really hard boss, by the way. This is a super hard boss. Oh my gosh, would you stop it with this? Well, we got him. He took a whole bunch of damage to do it. But we got him. Rubidine prototype. So we got a key and a bunch of money. And I think I'm gonna go so far as to... I want to see how much these cost again. They cost keys, that's right. They cost keys, which would be the same as opening a chest. How many keys do we have for sale here? I've got the Potion of Gun Friendship, which might be worth it. I'm pretty sure it's inactive. We've got one key, one armor, and the Potion of Gun Friendship. So I'm gonna take this. Temporary plus one to gun. Okay, we'll take a key. Got 20 bullets. So, if I go here, I can open both of these. I can get health and armor, which will be nice. And then it's basically the choice of... Ooh. Angry bullets. I will go so far as to... come through here and blow up this chest. I will use my basic gun, since it of course has infinite ammo. We get junk, but that's not unexpected. I'm gonna go back to this statue. Because this statue, if I'm correct, is the one where you get rid of a gun for a health. So, which gun am I not ever going to use? The grenade launcher was interesting. I'm never gonna use the Dungeon Eagle. That's worth a heart to me. We've got a bunch of extra guns. We're going to the fifth floor, ladies and gentlemen. This is like the second time I think I've made it to this floor. Is it? It might be the third. I'm gonna try using the Rubidine prototype. This is exciting. The Forge. Oh my god, that's amazing. The ricochet is real. Okay, and ammo? What's... grenade launcher? The grenade launcher was decent. Hello, saw. I like the Rubidine, though. Oh my gosh, do I like the Rubidine. That was very unfortunate. Get out of this room as fast as possible. Alright. Oh my gosh. I did not even see that. That is my own bad. He's just exuding bullets. It's actually a little insane. He's just exuding bullets. I thought I was getting shot there. Sadly, the Rubidine runs out of ammo really fast. I mean, speaking of, I'm not going to push my luck in terms of mentioning ammo. There's a lot of enemies on this floor that I don't know exactly what to expect out of them. Cleared that room. I'm still doing really good with bullets. Like, that's the thing I wasn't particularly expecting. I'm using my gun of friendship! Oh, I got hit. Alright, okay, you know what? I haven't actually checked what Angry Bullets does, and I want to know. Hitting an enemy has a chance to refire the projectile at a nearby enemy. Oh, maybe that's what's going on here, and not the Rubidine itself. Okay, I kind of got lucky in guessing that that's what would happen. Aw, yeah. So the Rubidine might not really be all that great. Oh gosh, I thought that was cover for some crazy reason. I wonder what that means for the grenade launcher. I need to get rid of him. I don't know, I still think the Rubidine is ricocheting. And it's like a combination of the fact that it ricochets mixed with the fact that it's possibly refiring bullets. I'm in a bad position right now. I need you to die. Alright, so this is empty. So let's switch to the SAA. Oh gosh. The SAA also ricochets, which means it could be really good with these angry bullets. Simple enough. This is probably leading back to this. I'll take it. I need to keep my eye out for my cash buddy friend. It's a blue chest. It's not the greatest. It doesn't have a timer on it, so I'm not too concerned about it. A gun muncher. Okay. I could make use of that. The Rubidine was okay. I'm not gonna use the flare gun. I'm probably not gonna use the proton pack. It was cool, but dodge rolling breaks the stream. I mean, I might be making a huge mistake here. I can't feed it that. I want to feed it the flare gun. Give me something good to eat. The vertebrae would be beautiful. Okay, this is the hot new gun for you. Laser rifle? Don't get me wrong. I like lasers, and I kind of like rifles. So, I don't know, sounds like fun. I'm going to give it a shot for at least a room, see how it goes. I'm just checking for cash, dude. For my secret room mentor. We made it to the forge. It's been a long time since anyone has come down here. Come to kill your past? Okay, so, sorry, I already know what's going on here, so I'm going to go through the dialogue as though I didn't. If you thought it was going to be that easy, I've got some bad news for you. What do you mean? The gun that kills the past, like everything else, it needs ammunition. Otherwise, well, what stopped time here? That's old magic. If you find the gun, it may fire, but how far back will you go? You might just find yourself right back here again. You want to get out of this place and change something about your past, right? To tear a hole that far back, you'll need a special bullet. I can make it for you, but the materials might prove hard to find. Tell me what you need. To make the bullet, I'll need the prime primer lost in the upper chambers, some arcane gunpowder mined in the heart of the Gungeon, a shard of planar lead broken off from the great bullet when it struck, and an obsidian shell casing bored from the tooth of a great beast. Bring all of that to me over many lifetimes, and I will aid you in your quest. That's your way of saying, if you bring it to me once, you won't need to bring it to me again. You're back. I have something for you. You brought me the prime primer. Here. I give her the prime primer. We will never have to buy it again. I see you brought me the planar lead. Here. The planar lead. Thank you. The bullet still requires more material, so we won't have to go through that shenanigans ever again. Alright, Old Knight's Helm. The hammer. That sounds amazing, by the way. A key and some health. You can actually walk on this. I freaked out watching this and thinking it was going to do bad stuff. It's actually a triple shot. I'm sadly not impressed. I mean, ammo efficient, sure. Does the hammer keep going? I wasn't sure. I wasn't gonna just let it sit there. So the laser rifle is not all that great, it seems. Oh god, we found it. We found the final boss. Do I do it? Do I go for it? Or just let it slip? I actually would like to buy the helm. I need 6 more bullets. I would like also to find the secret room, because it might have armor or health in it. But I also kind of want all my blanks. I'm still going to see if I find them. If I don't find them, I'm not going to bother. I think I'm going to go fight the final boss. But I want the helm. I basically need to not get hit for this to be effective. Only 3. I need 6. Well, now I need 3, but were there no bullets to get? Oh my gosh. No bullets still? Oh my gosh, you fiend. Beautiful. Alright. Let's do this. I have a key, don't I? Yes, I do. Let's see what's in this chest. The pulse cannon. Looks good. Let's buy the helm. The hammer also looks good, but I would not be able to afford that. Gave me armor. 2 armor. I'm feeling good. So this, that looks pretty good. Alright, what am I going to open with? I'm going to open with, not the laser rifle, that was weak. I'm going to open with this. first time fighting this boss. And now for the best pun ever. You've probably already guessed it. The High Dragun. Positive side. Okay, so this gun's actually taking a... It doesn't really make it. Okay, the grenade launcher isn't doing diddly. I'm getting myself some allies here. Hello. I'm not... Luckily, I can keep my mouse trained in the same place and just focus on dodging. Being by the edge of the screen definitely makes it possible to dodge all three of those. Oh, God. Ricocheting bullets, darn it. Ricocheting bullets are not something I'm good at predicting. Alright, we are on to the second form. Alright, so the second form is neat. I want a high damage... It looks like the sling is what I want. That was bad. Maybe I want the SAA. Maybe I want the SAA. I'm taking a couple shortcuts here. Some of them are ricocheting back. I think we got this. I think we got this. As long as I don't really mess this up. I didn't really mess it up, I just partially messed it up. Yes! Alright. Slayer. Also. Guess what? It's the obsidian shell casing. I have something for you. You know what's funny? I didn't even use my plus one. Well, it still requires more materials. So, I was definitely correct in that I needed the healing thing. But that extra, literally, 3.5 hearts was all the difference. So, we of course don't have the perfect ending. Because we don't have the bullet. But, Mr. Marine, you are the first to have made it to the gun. And of course, I now have control over this. And bam!
Enter the Gungeon. Enter the Gungeon.
And credits. Thank you guys for watching. I know it took a really long time to get this first win, but I can focus less on the shenanigans. Less on the shenanigans of getting things. Now I just have to get the arcane gunpowder. And then I can just focus on getting to the end. I don't have to worry about all that stuff. This song is hilarious. Just enjoy it. Wow. I'm happy. I'm happy. I started off doing pretty good. We started off on a decent tear. I was a little disappointed we didn't get the master bullet from the master chamber from the first boss, but even though we've beaten the game, quote unquote, there's still a lot more going on here. There's a hidden character, there's actually killing your past, there's another level beyond this as well. These are just things that I've seen from watching other people play. That doesn't mean that everything's even been found yet. No guarantee. It's quite possible, but no guarantee. So there's still going to be a lot more content coming out for this game, believe you me. Or at least content for my channel, I mean. I don't know if they're going to be adding more stuff to the game, though I would love to see them add more stuff to the game. This is an Isaac-level roguelike. I can see this being a staple in a schedule of recordings of being slowly released. I can see it. I don't know if that's how it's going to be. Graphic cards or video cards are being announced really pretty much all the time now. We're waiting for a couple other announcements and whatnot. If you're not savvy with video cards, then don't even worry about it. If you're looking for a video card, you probably already know what's going on. If not, I'm not your best source. But with the advent of that new card, I will likely be able to return to the other games that I was doing. But I still want to keep playing this game. I'm having a lot of fun with it. And I hope you guys are enjoying this content as much as I am enjoying creating it. I think I've got 4 steady viewers that are watching every single one of these videos, and if you are one of those 4, thank you guys for watching these. I know some of them are pretty insufferable when I'm playing poorly. But that said and done, the Gungeon still holds mysteries. Gun Soul has joined the shootout. Dragun Fire. Nobody, you did great. That was, oh god, that was a long run. Look at all the stuff we got though. Good shit. Whew. Let's go back to the breach. I would like to spend our hegemony credits now, rather than later. In celebration, of course. So you can see, this is the bullet. We don't yet have the arcane gunpowder for it, but we're getting there. And that's what counts. Do we have any more acquisition? Yes, we do. And look at that, 15 credits. That's what the kind of stuff you get. Bloody eye patch, Raiden coil, that sounds amazing. Heart purse is probably another HP up, or a gunny, that's interesting. Raiden coil just sounds badass. Eye patch, bloody eyes. I actually think I know what bloody eyes does. Okay, we're gonna try this. And this. Alright, so we have spent our credits. I will stop rambling and say thank you guys for watching. Thank you very much. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I am stoked. I will see you next time, and until then, keep your guns loaded and your gears turning.